Virginia by a bucket as we get ready for the start of the second half. The previous time these two teams met, Bob Valvano, it was 28-28 at halftime. Almost the same score, but Costner trying to change things here for North Carolina State in the second half.
Our guys on our Star Watch certainly showed you why we feature them, and Costner showed the versatility of his game. Watch him on the long skip pass here, gets the wide open three and knocks it down. But he certainly makes his living inside to out. Watch here. Squares up, will fake, spin, another fake, up and under, draws the contact three-point play. And then, of course, Mark, Frank Young doing what he does best. He had three of the four three-pointers for West Virginia open on the wing. NC State loses him a little bit in transition here, just a second too late. That's all it takes. Young, three three-pointers in the first half.
Take a look at the field goal percentage. West Virginia right around 43%. And you look at the bench points in favor of West Virginia. You kind of expected that. North Carolina State only going 17. But we were talking about it, Bob, during the break. If you're North Carolina State, you have ambivalent feelings. Do you feel good about the fact that you're down just two, or do you feel bad about the fact that you're not doing some of the things that you should be doing?
I mean, it's a dangerous recipe. They've made 9 turnovers, only created 4. They're only shooting 33%. Those are the things that'll get you beat against West Virginia. But despite that, they're only down a bucket, so you think if we can just break it up a bit and not do things like that, they can get back in the game. A turnover against the 1-3-1.
1-3-1 causing havoc for the Pack. Ruoff knocks down the three ball.
Again, it's worth mentioning they have never trailed in this NIT. And every time NC State gets close, they find a way to make a play. Another deflection there by Young. Lots of deflections.
Costner kicks it outside. Now they go back down on the block. The double team predictably comes. Costner slips loose and gets the layup underneath. They've moved it around well that time.
If you get it to the middle, you got a fighting shot. In most zones, and certainly that one, the challenge is to get it to the middle without the ball being deflected or stolen. They have an unbelievable amount of steals. 278, only 186 for NC State. Give you an idea of the discrepancy.
Costner with 14 points now. Nichols out top. Alexander was conspicuous by his silence in the first half. Missed the layup. The follow missed by Rob Summers, and here come the Pack with an opportunity to come within one. They go inside. The double team comes once again. And no foul call as McCauley tried to draw the contact. Nichols kicks it out to Ruoff, left wide open. Back up court, that's Sewell. Nice feed underneath, and boy, Fellows blew an easy layup. Nichols. And he gave it right back to North Carolina State. Costner almost gave it back to the Mountaineers. 5 turnovers for West Virginia. They took great care of the basketball in the first half. That's a little two-man game with McCauley. McCauley on the post up. On the baseline, wide open, and we are tied at 31 as Costner hits his second three-pointer of the ball game. His teammates call him Big Lazy, but he's given big effort in this game. We're knotted at 31. A trip to New York on the line here.
I don't think there's any question both these teams really want to make it to Madison Square Garden.
And Frank Young leads the chant for the Mountaineers every time they break the huddle. The chant says back to New York. That's what they yell when they break the huddle. 2-point lead for the Mountaineers. Costner out to Atsur. And Atsur gives the Wolfpack the 1-point lead, which is significant in the fact that it's the first time that the Mountaineers have ever trailed in the tournament.
That is a remarkable run. What is that? 40, 80, 100, 103 minutes, I guess, right?
Your math is better than mine.
Oh, I got it right back.
And it lasted pretty quick. Alexander with his first field goal of the game.
Oh, that's great composure. He took a lot of guys who were in reserve roles last year, John Beilein, thrust them into prominent roles this year the old school way, and these guys responded. And it's been a remarkable, as you said, overachieving season for the Mountaineers.
Picked to finish 12th in the conference. McCauley got blocked. Costner got stripped. Mountaineer basketball, Young on the deck. And here's Ruoff. Ruoff on spin cycle and fouled by Atsur. a flurry of activity.
All right, take a look at the first play. Watch the great defensive rotation here. Watch them form the double team. And then watch the defensive slide down there, gives him nothing and creates the turnover. Now, how do you beat it, Mark? You need a diagonal pass. Watch the diagonal pass out of the trap. There's the double team right there. And now this is the diagonal pass that's going to be open. Once they make that, it opens things up. Defender rotates out, kick to the corner, and the three. Nice job against what's been a pretty effective double team for the Mountaineers.
Yeah, Kit Sidney Lowe lamenting the fact that that 1-3-1 is so efficient, so good defensively for the Mountaineers at taking away passing lanes, especially that pass to the corner. But on that sequence we showed on the replay, the breakdown, they were able to break down the defense, but the Mountaineers get the lead back, and boy, Grant bringing a little bit of funk.
Yeah, but that's Ingonazzo recognizing that they were anticipating the pack getting into a half-court set. He fronted the ball with a sense of urgency and a nice finish by Grant.
Always nice when you can get an easy one to the offensive end. Here's Ruoff with the drive-by on Fells, and Fells fouled him. Grant was in a rush. And Atsua with the nice hit ahead. That's how you finish. An education and termination. Back with more right after this. North Carolina State down by a bucket with 15:56 to go in the MasterCard NIT quarterfinal action. West Virginia with the lead. And hey, we want to congratulate the North Carolina State Wolfpack women's basketball team defeating Baylor by 6 in overtime. And Kay Yao leading her team into the Sweet 16, into the regional finals. And what a year it's been for Kay Yao. Going up against a very insidious disease, cancer, battling that, and showing a lot of courage and insolence in doing so, and fighting a great battle so far. And you would know about that with your late brother going through the same thing, ultimately losing his battle.
They were very close. She's been on our board at the V Foundation, and this is the third time she's fighting it and doing it with great determination, as you said. Very inspiring story.
Back the other way, it's Grant. And North Carolina State with an opportunity to tie the basketball game. Atsua out top.
We talk about NC State's resilience. How about West Virginia? They were headed for the first time in this postseason. They gave up a lead for 17 whole seconds.
Is that how long it was? David Beck. Grant on the wing, back out top to Costner. Sid Lowe holds down two fingers, calls out another offensive set. Nice slip screen by McCauley. Couldn't get the bounce. Rebounded nicely by Rob Summers. Mountaineers have numbers. Nichols had it knocked away, and that's going to be a foul against Atsua. Ingen Atsua leading the way for Sid Lowe's crew. It's been a tough season for him. Missed 12 games with a hamstring injury. And really has had a tough time getting his rhythm back. But boy, if there ever was a monument to courage, it was that game against Duke. And he came back and scored 21 points all in the second half in the ACC tournament to lead that comeback victory for the Wolfpack against the Blue Devils. And Atsur telling me earlier today that he plans on playing for the Turkish national team once again this summer in the European Championships. That's going to be taking place in Barcelona, Spain. Actually had a nice conversation with Higo Turgulu, a countryman and a member of the national team, now a member of the Orlando Magic. Higo invited him to a Orlando Magic game in Charlotte recently, but Atsur had other commitments, like playing a game of his own.
Played 137 minutes in 4 days in Florida in the ACC tournament with a bad hammy. How about that?
Wow. Costner
with the double.
Double team came on the dribble that time. And he gets swarmed. Weak side to Grant. 7 on the shot clock for the Wolfpack. Grant with a nice foray to the bucket, and he's fouled on the process. Gavin Grant will go to the free throw line. They went deep into the shot clock. That's his second foul.
Costner in a double team here. Here comes the trap. Young forms it. Now he's in trouble, and he's trying to create space for himself, backing up, then stands up, a little bump. Crowd wanted to travel, wanted to charge, wanted something, but
he sharpened those elbows before the game.
He survived, got it out of there, and led to the foul. But they've done a pretty good job, West Virginia. You see that, we showed it to you earlier, the good hard double team and then that weak side rotation. Unless you can get the ball to that opposite wing, it's a long, difficult possession.
Kevin Grant knocking down a couple of foul shots, shooting 74% on the season. A much better game tonight for him rather than the first meeting against West Virginia when he committed 8 of their 17 turnovers. But in fairness to him, he was playing out of position in that game because Atsuer was out with a hamstring injury. They moved him to the point. Butler with the left-handed layup way off the mark. And now the Wolfpack with yet another opportunity to tie the basketball game or take the lead on a three-pointer.
Look at Atsuer. Just as soon as he gets it across midcourt, everybody feels like we're in good hands now. Get to your spots, run your sets, and we'll get good shots. That's what Sidney Lowe tried to persuade these guys. Take what you want, not just what they'll give you.
Grant got a decent look at it, working off the bounce, and here's Nichols back the other way. Smoligan doesn't hesitate, in rhythm.
That's a beautiful bit of transition. That's West Virginia basketball at its best. Everybody a passer, everybody a threat to shoot it. You lose a guy in transition, who, by the way, happens to be 7 feet tall, makes you pay 3 points worth.
This is a team that shoots 37% from downtown. Fells from downtown. Quiets the crowd here, a near sellout of 12,000 with a three ball of his own.
First one blocked, got it back, perseverance, gets his first three-pointer. We got a good one.
Sure do. 13:22 to go in the second half. On the line tonight, a trip to New York. The winner of this game will take on Mississippi State in the semifinals next week. That's going to be a foul against the Mountaineers. And here's a look at what's coming up tomorrow in the MasterCard NIT. Syracuse taking on Clemson at 7 o'clock, and then at 9, DePaul faces Air Force, the number one seed, at 9 Eastern time. Jeff Bisdelic's crew having a pretty good year and bouncing back from their late season disappointment. And inside, it's Costner tying the game at 43. Boy, he is a very precocious and talented redshirt freshman.
The credit for that goes to Fells. He's the one that recognized the 1-3-1, drove it to the gap, kicked it out, made the defense have to rotate, and wound up on the second pass to land for Costa.
Nichols on the baseline.
Good ball move.
Frank Young from downtown off the mark. Smoligan battling underneath, but North Carolina State comes up with it. The Wolfpack have led for all of, as you said, just about 17 seconds in this game. But a chance to take the lead here. Wolfpack in the midst of a 5-0 mini run. That's through a little two-man game. Costner, the three ball, way off the mark.
Well, it was apparent 5 minutes into this, these two teams are playing very hard to get to New York, and a great finish by Ruoff. Mark, these two teams, as I said, are giving their coaches the ultimate compliment. They simply don't want to stop playing. Every coach wants that at the end of the year.
Ruoff took that one almost 94 feet, baseline to baseline, breaking at Sewer's ankles on that one and finishing it with the left. We'll be back with more after this. Virginia players have 212 degrees written on the back of their warm-up jerseys. That is their postseason credo. John Beilein is pressing every motivational button he can. The 212 degrees is used as an example of incremental effort. He's telling his players that, guys, at 211 degrees Fahrenheit, water is just hot water. At 212 degrees, water boils. That extra increment is the extra increment of effort that we have to give to start boiling, to start cooking, to be successful here in the postseason. And so far, it has worked.
Great teachers are great communicators. And all you have to do is go watch one walkthrough. He's a master communicator, Mark, no question. If you can learn the shorthand.
Well, it's 100 degrees Celsius, 212 Fahrenheit. Didn't want to go there, but I had to throw that in. Horner missing.
He doesn't have any European players. Like if he had Atzer, he might have to bring that up.
Right.
Celsius.
Let's leave kilograms and all that other metric stuff alone, please. 11 and a half minutes to go here at West Virginia Coliseum. The winner of this game takes on Mississippi State in the semifinals next week in New York. Nichols with the
tip.
Got his own tip in amongst the trees. Darius Nichols. His nickname is Sneaky to his teammates. That was a nice sneaky tip.
Let's see if the Pack has an answer again. Nope, turnover.
Nichols again in the middle of it. Up to Young.
Oh, it's a charge. A nice defensive play. What hasn't Costner done, Mark?
Everything.
Made the three, post plays, making free throws, and now just as it's getting wobbly, he creates a turnover. Terrific defensive play.
You got to generate enough heat if you're West Virginia. 212 degrees is where you start to boil, and every winning recipe pretty much starts with boiling water, right? Back with more.
They favor the home team, but Pack just won't go away.
See what Sidney Lowe runs coming out of his timeout. Rossner double teamed underneath. They swing it around baseline. Weak side. Tough shot that time by Horner. Out of bounds, and that's going to be North Carolina State basketball. So they get another opportunity and a reset on the shot clock.
This should be a very well-schooled team, NC State, with all the point guards they've got on their coaching staff. Monty Tao is a point guard on the national championship team under Norm Sloan in 74, or Sidney Lowe on the Brother Jim's team in 83. Pete Strickland, another coach, played point guard at Pitt. Quentin Jackson, who's the director of basketball operations, is a point guard under my brother as well. I don't know who teaches the postman, though.
maybe that's why they're so proficient at Soar from outside. Haven't had a chance to tamper with the bigs yet. And at Soar cuts the lead down to a point.
Is that diagonal pass again, Mark, out of that trap? That's the one that can beat that double team.
9 points in the ball game for at Soar. Nichols out top, little two-man game with Smalligan, who rolled to the bucket. Nichols got tripped up.
And
it's a turnover.
Etzer fell down. I don't know if he hurt his hamstring again. I'm trying to watch him. It looked like he grimaced. Take a look. Etzer, like you've seen the tail end of it, he kind of let him go. He had slipped before that. Which Beeline not happy about that.
North Carolina State with an opportunity here to take the lead. Grant out top. Atsur. Grant working against Alexander. Tough play and a good block, but a foul called by Joe Alexander on the play. Grant had him isolated at the top and was intent on taking him to the cup.
He's such a terrific athlete, Alexander. You can see the body contact. Good call, but you know, you make a great point. That foul trouble early, he's never gotten into the rhythm this game. He's only got 3 points, and that's a big factor for them. He has made some dunks that are just igniting and momentum turners.
Grant, meanwhile, ties the game at 47 as Frank Young comes in for Smalligan. North Carolina State 10 of 12 from the free throw line tonight. Gavin Grant, a native of the Bronx, St. Raymond's High School in New York. So many great players have come out of that program. Leads the team in minutes played and misses the free throw, leaving the game tied at 47. 9.5 minutes to play. Six tie the ball game tonight. Whistle and a foul underneath. That's going to go against Courtney Fells as we go back to Reese Davis in the studio for this 30 and 30 update.
All right, Mark, there will be a new champion in women's college basketball. The Maryland Terrapins fall to Armenti Price and Ole Miss. Maryland as a 2 seed is out. Ole Miss forced Maryland into more than 20 turnovers and led to their upset. Glenn Davis is going to skip his senior season at LSU to enter the NBA draft. Much more coming up on SportsCenter after the game. ESPN News is on all the time.
All right, thanks a lot, Reese. So LSU losing a couple players in consecutive years. Tyrus Thomas last year. This year is going to be Big Baby Davis leaving early. 10 on the shot clock for Ruoff. Got to get work. Got to get busy. And he gave it up. Wolfpack with a chance for the lead here. Grant knocks it down. Butter. And that's just their second lead of the ball game. 49-47 now, North Carolina State.
And again, worth mentioning, only the second time West Virginia has trailed in the entire NIT here in this postseason run of theirs.
A disbelieving look etched across the countenance of John Beeline. A 6-0 run by the Pack.
Uncharacteristic, a turnover. West Virginia terrific, usually taking care of the basketball. And then because of the turnover, they can't get their defense set. And Grant, great composure to make that little mid-range jumper.
Costner with 19 for the Pack. Grant with 12. It's the Mountaineers. Ruoff with the three ball gives them the lead. And he strikes a pose with the follow through.
That's what they talked about today in their walkthrough. That was out of the timeout. He faked the cut to the goal. Ruoff stepped back, sprung himself free and a big momentum shifting three. Good job out of that timeout.
Grant picks it back outside and Fells knocks down the long range jumper.
And these two teams, I mean, this tournament, since the NCAA has taken over the NIT, really, Mark, it's a terrific event. Makes 97 teams that go to the postseason out of 336. I think compare that with football or 60 or whatever out of 112. Right. I mean, these are good teams playing meaningful games right now.
Ruoff missing, but Frank Young battling underneath. And one! Frank Young has get money written on those kicks of his. He's getting second chance points underneath here. 7:47 to go. Deadlocked at 52. Young with 13 when we come back. A loquacious, vociferous crowd here in the West Virginia Coliseum. Deadlocked at 52. With 7:47 to go, Frank Young ready to step to the free throw line. Frank Young had 16 against North Carolina State the last time these two teams met. Trying to work up to that total, and if he connects on this free throw tonight, it'll be his 500th point of the season. It has been a very prolific year for the senior from Tallahassee, Florida.
Had a career high 31 against UMass. And you know what the numbers, though, after the break show why NC State's come back. As he completes the three-point play, they are plus one in turnovers, and they're dead even now in three-point shooting, Mark. Eight for each team. That was the, those were the two areas where West Virginia had them in the first half, and traditionally beats people pretty soundly as you take a look at the stat track.
And the Mountaineers had 13 threes in the earlier meeting.
Yeah, but NC State only had three. They've already got eight today.
Good ball movement, and Grant can't connect from the baseline. Ruoff back in a rush for West Virginia. And Atsur wisely showing a lot of moxie on the court, drawing the offensive foul, drawing compliments from his head coach.
This is, he's doing a little bit of everything. Good quick feet. Extended arm by Ruoff.
That's an easy call.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
Wolfpack with a chance to take the lead here. Looking inside. Atsur guarded by Nichols. 15 on the shot clock for the Wolfpack. Now they go inside to Costner. Costner forced it up against the double team, and it falls.
How did he get it off, let alone make it?
Wow, 21 points for the redshirt freshman. He's just one rebound away from a double-double tonight. Wolfpack with a one-point lead. The winner of this one goes to New York.
Great cut.
Frank Young with the three ball. Got it!
Great cut by Young. That was terrific work without the basketball. Wow. And very frustrating for Grant to look over at Sidney Lowe like, yeah. I did everything I could do.
Yeah, exactly. Courtney Fells into the paint. Grant with a long stride to the bucket. No call. Fells missing. Aggressive, indefatigable work on the boards by North Carolina State. And Horner gets it to fall. They had a number of cracks at it and cashed in.
That possession is a microcosm of their season, I think, Mark. Take a look. This is the Costner basket. Young at the other end with a terrific play away from the ball. And then this possession, Mark, they thought they got fouled. They're complaining about the official, guys on the deck, guys screaming for foul. They missed the bunny, ball's knocked around. They come up with it, get fouled, just sheer willing in the goal. It's kind of been the story of their postseason, hasn't it?
Baba, I think I see some mushroom clouds forming over the key there. There are some detonations and some explosions as North Carolina State takes a one-point advantage.
Young again, nice movement without the ball.
Great cut by Young and gets a soft touch, nods his head and says, I'm a shooter, you gotta stick me.
That's one of the things they talked about today. John Beilein talking about snipers. You know what snipers do? They hit people. We need our snipers to hit people with the ball and let the scorers put it in the hole. He's one of the scorers.
And that's where, meanwhile, Bob fouled on his foray to the bucket. North Carolina State with 16 fouls, West Virginia with five.
Look at this cut. Great cut. And then a good presence of mind to step back and create just enough space for himself to get the shot off. Took a look in the lane, didn't like what he saw by taking it all the way to the hole. Just step back, gets the two-pointer.
West Virginia with 17 fouls. As North Carolina State now steps to the free throw line. At Soar, a good free throw shooter on the season at 78%. Sure, going over to the officials and asking it appeared to be some sort of relief or something. I'm not sure.
Ruoff, he was complaining, I think, came into him before. I'm not sure whether it was too hard or making contact with him on the follow through the free throw. It didn't seem to faze him.
1 point lead for the Wolfpack. It was at about this point in the last meeting, 3.5 months ago, where West Virginia took control of the game by connecting on 4 three-pointers to blow it open. And eventually won by 11 points. A layup in the tip, no good by Summers.
Nichols had a great opportunity, tried to put it with the right hand and missed it. And that was exactly what John Beilein wanted. Got a great cut. As we said, they get a lot of basket cuts for layups. Had a chance, couldn't get it.
You could probably count, Bob Valvano, on one hand the number of times that Sidney Lowe hasn't called out an offensive set in this game. At Soar off the mark from downtown. Great rebound by Fells. Out of bounds. And that's going to be a foul called against the Mountaineers.
Wow. Undercut, I guess, is the call. Spectacular bit of rebounding by Fells, who came in from the weak side. Take a look. Watch him come out of the left side of your picture, and then they called it on Nichols backing into Fells. Tough call there.
Fells rattles home the first one.
If anything, it looks like Nichols is backing. He's backing into Koster. He's pushing Koster out of bounds, and just along the way, he picked up Fells accidentally.
For North Carolina State, 13 of 16 from the free throw line now. 13 to 17 tonight, a 2-point lead under 5 minutes to go.
Now that is one category the Pack has a huge advantage. 535 made free throws this year, just 372 for West Virginia coming into the game. So they do get to the line a lot more frequently than the Mountaineers.
Did you explain that with the proclivity for the three-pointers like Ruoff just let fly?
Absolutely. They don't play a lot of power basketball. But they do make some great basket cuts. They are not a gimmick team, as we talked about. And they had a chance on that possession prior for layup, missed it, and then the open three doesn't go. And now the Pack getting a little confidence.
North Carolina State with possession in a 2-point lead. At Soar looking inside for Costner. The double teams have been coming quickly, as in on the catch. 12 on the shot clock. Costner trying to seal his man inside. Grant forced it up. Didn't hit the rim, and thank you very much, says Horner on the room service. Missed shot.
Wow.
What about that?
Sometimes it pays to be, you make your luck when you hustle.
An 8-2 Wolfpack run has them leading by 4 with under 4 minutes to play.
I'm sure Sidney Lowe would love to go back to New York. You know, he once won in the Holiday Festival, as we get a timeout by John Beilein here. This is a great stat. The first year he was playing for my brother Jim, he won the MVP in the Holiday Festival in New York without scoring a field goal. He played the entire tournament there, didn't score a field goal, and he still won the MVP. I would think he's got some great memories of Madison Square Garden. I'd love to take the team back there for this overachieving run by the late season in the Wolfpack.
Speaks to Sidney Lowe's great leadership skills as a point guard, and now doing the same from a coaching aspect. And if North Carolina State wins this game, it would be the third time that they go to New York for the semifinals in the NIT. And let's talk about the strategy from here on in. If you are West Virginia right now, what do you have to do in this sequence?
Well, the first thing right now, they have to run one of the things they talked about at their walkthrough, a little wrinkle out of those many, many options they have in a half-court set. Get a good look and then settle down and realize you just got to get a stop at the other end. But the big thing is, let's see what kind of a wrinkle they run here. Will it be for a basket cut for layup? Something for Frank Young looking for a three? But I promise you, they'll give him a little bit of a wrinkle. And as we said, try and get a bucket here and then set that defense with it. I'd be curious to see if they do score, they go 1-3-1 or man-to-man, because in the man-to-man, Sidney Lowe's just pulling out the whole NBA bag of tricks here and getting lots of good looks.
Here we go with 3:45 to go. West Virginia's last field goal came almost 3 minutes ago now.
That was
Frank Young. That's what they drew up. Oh. I'm not sure that they drew up the bank shot.
Well, it was a good play enough. NC State got a lucky one at one end. They got a lucky one at the other one. They're even. Although that was a three.
The after-hours ATM card used by Frank Young. 22 points for him.
Stay back in the man-to-man, though.
Costner on the dribble, working nicely, but couldn't finish. Summers with the rebound.
Big stop for West Virginia there.
Approaching 3 minutes to go. Mountaineers facing a one-point deficit.
Just as many calls being made for the Mountaineer bench. Beilein makes the call for his hot shooter.
Frank Young's butter. Like another guy that went to school here who earned the nickname Mr. Clutch, Frank Young is proven to be just that right now down the stretch. First, it was the bank shot coming out of the timeout. That's what preceded the other three.
But you know what? This is what they do so well. They decide in a timeout who's going to get the shot for them, and that guy gets the shot. You don't stop him. They've been lucky he banked it. But these two possessions, they put the ball in exactly the player's hand they wanted, and he's responded with six quick points.
Frank Young, who earlier in this game set the school record for three-pointers made, telling me before the game that setting that mark would be important to him. He says, when you consider all the great players that have come through the program here at West Virginia, and most recently, guys like Mike Ganzi, former teammate of his, Kevin Pitsnoggle as well, it would mean a lot that his name would remain in the record books for however long, for posterity's sake.
Now let's see. I'm surprised, really. They haven't shown him 1-3-1. NC State didn't look particularly comfortable against him. Staying in the man-to-man. Let's see who the pack goes to. Going inside to Costner. At least they're looking there.
Maybe it's a save for a little bit later for John Beilein. But there are 2.5 minutes to go. Game with 8 lead changes, 8 ties and lead changes. Atsur, butter.
Oh, my goodness.
Ingen Atsur. In any language. All of which he speaks, English, French, German, Turkish, in any language, that's a big shot. He has 13. Ruoff countering for three.
This is just,
do you believe
this? These two teams are putting on clinics. This, if you don't like this, you're lying to yourself if you say you like basketball. Because these are kids playing their hearts out to go to New York, and two coaches giving you a half-court clinic offensively.
15 for Ruoff. Atsur, a little get back off the mark. Missed everything.
That was a little quick, perhaps.
It is raining threes in Morgantown. Frank Young. The glass. Atsur. Back at you. And Ruoff. Time to get off for him. Back with more. 147 and a trip to New York on the line. Been reigning supreme in the MasterCard NIT so far, and Mississippi State keeping to that trend earlier tonight, defeating Florida State in Starkville, Mississippi, moving on to the semifinals in New York next week.
NC State's bucked it once, winning at Drexel, trying to do it twice in a very difficult place to win, especially with John Beilein here. They have been almost unbeatable out of conference here.
And 31-2 at home against non-conference opponents. Great feed by Ruoff.
What a delivery.
Summers doesn't score often, but he got a big one there.
What a nice pass by Ruoff. Great presence of mind. Two possession game, huge.
Inside to McCauley, got good position. And it's out of bounds. It'll be North Carolina State basketball. Good dish by Ruoff.
The key thing right there is that he gave time for the play to throw. Just nice bit of not over-penetrating and going too quickly where you're out of control. Just nice little sense of timing there and put it right on the money for the big fella.
Ruoff has played a nice forward lane tonight.
He does that. You mentioned that earlier.
Swinging around weak side, 7 on the shot clock. Costner missed the first one and was fouled on the putback attempt by Frank Young. That stops the clock with 57.5 seconds to go. Mountaineers leading by 4. Each team with a couple of timeouts remaining. West Virginia with 9 team fouls. North Carolina State with only 5 team fouls.
Ruoff has more assists, by the way, than anybody on either roster. And I bring that up because down the stretch, you're going to want the ball in his hands, even though you normally think Darris Nicholas is the guy to maybe be the creator. Ruoff more assists, as we said, than anybody on either roster.
Oh boy, a costly miss, Bob, by Costner, hitting 72% from the foul line this year. All freshmen in the ACC and all freshmen All-America as well by several publications. Got to knock this down to make it a one possession game, which he does. Costner with 22 points. There's a look at what West Virginia has done going into the final minute under John Beilein. 94% of the time.
Now here it's Ruoff, and let's see. Now, they don't do a lot of stuff off the bounce. As we said, they create off the pass, but you would think it's going to go through him at some point.
North Carolina State, Bob, with a foul to give. They have just 5 team fouls.
That's bad for them. They don't want to foul now. Yeah. Give them a new 35. That would be a very bad thing right now.
Ruoff on the cut. And then they're going to wave it off. An offensive foul. They got him on the clear out with the off arm.
That's a terrific defensive play. A very, very difficult call. Watch. That's a pretty good job by McCauley of establishing position. That guy's got the basketball. You don't have to give him room. Both feet are on the floor. He gets it right between the 3 and the 4. That's a pretty good defensive play.
And McCauley taking one and 31 seconds to go. There's a look at our game reset. North Carolina State with just one timeout remaining now. After burning this timeout that we're in right now, West Virginia with a couple left. It'd be interesting to see what Sidney Lowe runs here coming out of the timeout. Costner has been one of their go-to guys down low. And is this now the time that John Beilein, Bob, goes back to that 1-3-1, which we haven't seen much of since pretty much the middle part of the first half?
And I thought they really had NC State off balance with it. You know, it's one of those things that could be a turnover, which could really seal the deal, or a long diagonal pass and you give up the 3, which is the one thing that you don't want to give up right here. So I will be interested to see what he plays. There's two ways to look at it, because obviously if they create a turnover, NC State's got to foul him twice just to get him in the 1-on-1. You already pointed that out. That's going to eat some time. So they've got to get a bucket here, NC State, whether it's a 2 or a 3, and then get in their defense very quickly. And if they want to foul, get those 2 fouls in the books very fast.
Little dribble handoff action.
They're looking for a 3, I think.
Some misdirection. That's what they go for. Fells came up short.
Now they got to foul twice, remember?
Well, Fells had a good look at it, and Courtney Fells has been shooting well for most of the postseason. They foul West Virginia with 19.1 to go.
Pretty good job. They ran a weave out front. As you said, misdirected it. Came back to the right. Got the 3, and now the quick foul on the inbound.
They foul the wrong guy. Nichols shoots 85% from the free throw line. Darris Nichols, 6'2 junior from Radford, Virginia. Had 11 points and 8 assists in the last run against North Carolina State.
Virginia trying to make it to New York for the first time in the NIT Final Four since 1981. They won the event back in 1942, and the whole tournament was in New York. But it's been a long time since they made it to the Big Apple for the Final Four in this event.
This year's Mountaineer team, really the big picture, has overachieved. And it underscores the wonderful coaching job by John Beilein, a team with 8 freshmen and just 1 returning starter from a season ago.
Oh my.
The miss by Nichols. A 1 possession game still, 14 seconds to go.
Same play, nope, something different.
Little flare, Fells again. And they're going to call a whistle and a timeout.
Oh, did that go in?
No, it didn't. With 10 seconds to go, Sidney Lowe burns a timeout. What if it would have gone in?
That would have been
on the timeout.
That would have been.
Let's not think about that for Sidney Lowe's
very bad turn of events.
Once again, Frank Young has been huge for the Mountaineers.
He has been just terrific. I love what he does away from the basketball. You get to see the end result, but away from the ball, the way he uses screens, the way he changes direction, 25.16 in the second. Look at that little flare off the screen that Summers gave him. This is the one right here where he comes in the lane, sees the defense, steps back, makes the mid-range shot. When this game got turned around and righted for West Virginia, he was the guy that put them on their shoulders. This game got very wobbly for them. He made back-to-back threes, and right now, it may be enough to propel him to the finish line.
10 seconds to go. Last time North Carolina State ran a little weave out top. A little bit of misdirection before Fells let the three fly. He actually let the last one fly on the timeout call.
Well, that was their last timeout. Let's see. Obviously, we've got something drawn up. Last time it was a weave out front and then a misdirection. Let's see where they go this time.
Costner is actually their best three-point shooter at 38%. McCauley, here's Grant. Grant.
Nope.
No way. Wide left.
Roll it.
But McCauley chased down the loose ball. Couldn't control it.
Very tough now. They got a foul immediately, and they need another front-end miss. Oh, they have a trouble getting it
in. They couldn't get it in. Oh, they caught a break, West Virginia did.
And he got hammered.
As two Wolfpack players collided, and Horner is lying on the court.
Oh,
got hit in the face.
Shot. Wow, this has been a very unusual last 10 seconds.
Boy, Ruoff, I'm not sure what he was thinking there on the inbound pass.
I know he took so long. He's holding his jersey. Young's got his jersey being held. And then the two guys both got in the passing lane.
Gravin Grant and Horner colliding
Grant
there. Horner
really
took the rest of the worst of it.
Grant gave him some shot.
Well, we have this break, and it's good to see Horner be able to lead the court under his own power. One more look at the draw. Mississippi State will take on the winner of this game next Tuesday on ESPN2 up in New York in the MasterCard NIT. Tomorrow, Clemson takes on Syracuse, followed by Air Force against DePaul. Let's see what happens on the inbound this time, whether they can get it in, and that's going to be a foul against North Carolina State on the inbound pass. Before it was actually inbounded.
Going to send Butler to the line, a 67% free throw shooter who hasn't shot any yet today. And again, remember, it's just single bonus, but NC State without a timeout, even if it's a miss on the front end, going to have to cover a lot of ground in 2 seconds here.
Butler on the season, Bob, a 67% free throw shooter. And this is his first attempt tonight. 2.2 to go. Pretty much ices it with that. Now two possession game.
Overachieving season. Team picked 12th in the Big East is going to New York for the Final Four of the NIT.
Well, they recently didn't get their goal accomplished there in the recent Big East tournament. So they have an opportunity at atonement up in New York. And the Mountaineers are going to storm up to New York City in Manhattan. 33rd and 7th, here we come. West Virginia wins.
These are teams, each of whom has a win over a team in the Sweet 16 in the NCAA. These are quality teams. Played a very entertaining game and a very worthy team going to New York in the Mountaineers. Great win for John Beilein and company.
Improved to 25-9 in the season, and all in all, a very good season for Sidney Lowe and the Wolfpack. Well, our final score, 71-66. There's been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. For Bob Valvano and the rest of our crew, I'm Mark Jones. So long from Morgantown, West Virginia. A reminder, if you'd like more on tonight's game, join us on ESPN News for a post-game extra. Right now, we're going to go to SportsCenter, joining Paul Ravitch and Stan Verrett. So long, everybody.